Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. In this video, we shall have topic 12, integration by trigonometric substitution. This is one of the last topic in calculus 2, MAT 200. Now, some of the questions in this topic are not brand new. We have seen them in some other forms, and some of these questions we have also done using some other methods. Now, we will be needing three trigonometric identities which we have seen before. First is sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Second is secant square theta minus tan square theta equal to 1. Third is cosecant square theta minus cot square theta equal to 1. See, the first and the second identity are more important than the third, because in most situations the first two identities suffice. Now, there are three scenarios which we will be seeing in this type in this chapter. First is integration of some power of a square minus x square, some power other than 1. If it is 1, we can directly integrate, we do not need any substitution. The first thing will first sub type will be a square minus x square with some power other than 1. Second will be a square plus x square. The power will not be 1. And the third will be x square minus a square. Again, the power is not 1. It can be half or plus half, minus half, 1, minus 1, not 1, sorry, minus 1, minus 2, something like that. Or some other combinations also. Now, if you have a square minus x square, you put x equal to a sine theta. If it is a square plus x square, try x equal to a tan theta. If it is x square minus a square, try x equal to a secant theta. A is some number, some real number. Now, if x equal to a sine theta, you will get sine theta equal to x by a, theta equal to sine inverse x by a. This has nothing to do with calculus. This is from your school geometry and trigonometry. Now, if you make this substitution a square minus x square, you will get a square minus a square sine square theta, which is a square into 1 minus cosine square, 1 minus sine square theta, which will become cosine square theta. So two things have become one by making this substitution. And you can use this triangle to calculate all the six quantities which you will have, which you may have in your answer. You don't have to calculate all six. By definition, you have this red color lines. It's actually purple. Sine theta equal to x by a. And the blue is the calculation using the Pythagorean theorem. You have a square minus x square under the root. You can calculate all the six ratios which you get in your answer, not all of them. Now, the same thing happens in other identities, other substitutions. A square plus x square will become x equal to a tan theta, a square plus a square tan square theta. Then you'll get a square take common 1 plus tan square theta, you will get a square secant square theta. See, two things have become one, and look at the triangle, you will get tan theta is x divided by a, which is in purple color, and the third side is given by the Pythagorean theorem, which is the hypotenuse. In this case, it is a square plus x square. This long side is called hypotenuse, opposite to the right angle. Then the last possible substitution is x square minus a square. Put x equal to a secant theta, you will get a square into secant square theta minus a square. Take a square common, you will get secant square minus 1. Use the second identity, you will get a square into tan square theta. Two things have become 1. When you have a power of half or minus half or 2 or something like that, it is very useful to make these two things into 1. We will see with numerical example. Until now, we did not talk about any calculus. Now, in your calculus, when you integrate, you have dx. So, dx equal to a cosine theta d theta. In this substitution, x equal to tan theta. So, dx equal to a secant square theta d theta. X equal to a secant theta, dx equal to a secant theta tan theta d theta. And again, you can do the same calculations in your in the triangle. Now we can also put cosine here in the first substitution, but you will get minus cos inverse somewhere when you work out the steps. Because when you work out the differentiation, you will get here minus a sin theta d theta. Similarly, in your answers, there will be some minuses. Instead of sine inverse, you will get cosine inverse or minus cosine inverse sometimes. Okay? So, if you want, you can use cosine in place of sine, but remember there will be a minus here and the answer will look different. You can use cotangent in place of tangent, but again there will be a minus here in the dx and there will be some minuses elsewhere also. Sines will become opposite. So, traditionally, they go for sine theta, tangent theta and secant theta. You can also use cosecant theta here. The third identity will work. It works almost perfectly all the time. They are equivalent. So, but normally, traditionally, most people use the substitution of sine here, tangent here and secant here with the a. You can use the other three also. Now let's look at the first question in this topic. Evaluate the integral 1 over 25 minus x square under the root a equal to square root of 25, which is 5. 25 equal to 5 square. You can take the help of your calculators if the numbers are not easy. You have to find the right 25 as 5 square. Now we'll put x equal to 5 sine theta, theta equal to sine inverse x by 5. We might need this in the answer, so I wrote it in anticipation. You don't have to write it at this stage. 25 minus x square is 5 square minus x square, 5 square minus 5 tan theta whole square. You get 5 square minus 5 square sine square theta. 5 square into 1 minus sine square theta is 5 square into cosine square theta. So under the root 25 minus x square will become 5 cosine theta. Now you integrate this. You can give this integral some name, which I have given it as I. If you want to give it a name like J or K, it is fine. 1 over 25 minus x square under the root is 1 over 5 cosine theta. What about dx? X equal to 5 sine theta, dx equal to 5 cosine theta d theta. We have 5 cosine theta d theta. See, this kind of substitutions we have also done in other chapters in a slightly different context. Now, cancel the 5, cancel the cosine, you are left with integration of 1 d theta. Integration of 1 is 1 dx is x plus c, 1 d theta is theta plus c. Now how much is theta? Your question is given in x, so your answer should be in x. Now x equal to 5 sine theta, that means theta equal to sine inverse x by 5. Please remember, sine theta is x by a, theta is sine inverse x by a. X equal to a, tan theta equal to x by a, theta equal to tan inverse. Some people write arc sine, arc cosine, arc tan and arc secant. You can do that, or you can write sine inverse. Please, some of you confuse this with power minus 1. There is no power minus 1 here. If it is a power minus 1, you have to put a full bracket for the whole thing and write power minus 1. So this is not 1 by sine theta. This is sine inverse x by a. And your calculator has sine inverse and cosine inverse. So theta equal to sine inverse x by 5 plus c. Now just remember, if the number was 9 square here, you will get x by 9 here. There is no number outside. Now you can differentiate and check this answer. And the differentiation rule is derivative of sine inverse is 1 over square root of 1 minus u square du by dx. Sine inverse u. Here u is x by 5, so you have 1 by 5 outside. Do the algebra here, you will get 25 minus x square under the root. Next question, we are only changing the numbers. Evaluate integration of 1 over 36 minus x square, not integration of, integral 1 over 36 minus x square dx. Now, a equal to square root of 36, which is equal to 6, 36 equal to 6 square, x equal to 6 sine theta, theta equal to sine inverse x by 6. Now 36 minus x square will be same as 6 square cos square theta. We'll get 36 minus x square under the root as 6 cosine theta. We have done a similar question, so I'm not going into detail. And dx equal to 6 cosine theta d theta. आप i इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल 1 ओवर 36 माइनस x स्क्वायर अंडर द रूट dx. नाउ यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल, द dx डू नॉट राइट d थीटा अलोन हियर, इट इज 6 cos थीटा d थीटा, राइट द कंप्लीट थिंग फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस स्टेप. एंड 36 माइनस x स्क्वायर इज 6 cosine थीटा. नाउ 6 विल कैंसिल, cosine विल कैंसिल, यू विल गेट 1 d थीटा. इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ 1 इज थीटा प्लस c. यू विल गेट sin इनवर्स x बाय 6. Look, it is 6 square, so we are getting x by 6. If it is 10 square, you will get x by 10. Again, you can differentiate and check the answer. And remember to write plus c in the last step of your answer. Now, this question is different from the last two questions. Evaluate 1 over 49 plus x square. Now, what substitution will you get? You will get secant square theta plus tan square theta equal to 1. So put x equal to 7 theta, a equal to square root of 49, which is 7, x equal to 7, tan theta, theta equal to tan inverse x by 7. We do not know sometimes what answer will come, but we can write it here in this step. Otherwise, you can write it after some time. Now 49 plus x square will be 7 square plus 7 tan theta whole square. You'll get 7 square plus 7 square tan square theta. 7 square into 1 plus 10 square is secant square. We'll get 7 square into secant square theta. And remember, whenever you do this kind of substitution in this chapter, two things become one. A square plus x square, a square minus x square minus a square plus a square, all four of them will become one, and there are only three, a square plus x square equal to x square plus a square. Now please remember x equal to 7 theta, we are doing calculus, so it is dx equal to 7 secant square theta d theta. Your calculus starts with dx. Now the integral I equal to 1 over 49 plus x square dx, this is 1 over 7 secant square theta d theta, so 7 square theta, and dx equal to 7 secant square d theta. Please remember there is no square root here, so do not take any square root here from your mind. Look at the question where the square root comes. Now the 7 will cancel, 1 7 you will get 1 by 7, the secant square will cancel, you will get 1. Integration of 1 is theta, 1 over 7 theta plus c. Now theta is tan inverse x by 7. In some questions you will get sine and cosine here, not in this. So in that case you have to use the triangle, we will do that kind of questions also. Now the fourth question, you have 1 over 64 plus x square, a equal to square root of 64, which is 8, 64 equal to 8 square, x equal to 8 tan theta, theta equal to tan inverse x by 8. 64 plus x square is equal to 8 square plus 8 tan theta whole square, you'll get 8 square plus 8 square tan square theta, take 8 square common, you'll get 1 plus 10 square, which is equal to secant square. Look, there's no square root, so don't put it. Now your calculus starts here, x equal to 8 tan theta, dx equal to, what's the derivative of tangent? Derivative of tangent is secant square. You have 8 secant square theta d theta. Now take the value, integral I equal to 1 over 64 plus x square dx, put everything together, this from this substitution and this from the dx. Now you'll get 1 over 8, secant square also cancels, 8 by 8 square is 1 over 8. Integration of 1 is theta, you have 1 over 8 theta plus c, which is 1 over 8 tan square x by 8. If you have 9 square in the question, you will get 1 by 9 x by 9. If you have a square in the question, you will get 1 over a tan inverse x by a. You can do that yourself as an exercise and see it. Again, differentiate your answer and check, you should get back the question, and which is indeed the case. Now we have the third type of substitution, evaluate 1 over x square minus 49. A equal to square root of 49, which is 7, 49 equal to 7 square, x equal to 7 secant theta, x square minus 49 is 7 square secant square theta minus 7 square, take 7 square common, you will get secant square theta minus 1, which is 7 square tan square theta. See, just remember, in your substitution in this chapter you'll get two things will become one and they will be positive. Please remember, these two things together should be positive, otherwise there can be problems. because the square root of negative number is not being going to be used by us. So we have to make sure that it is positive, because sometimes like these questions we have the square root. So two things should become one and should be positive. If it is negative, there are other methods to do it, but we are not going to use those methods. They work, but in this chapter the square root has to be positive. 1 divided by x square minus 49 is your main thing in the integration. It is 1 over 7 tan theta. Now your integration starts here. Dx equal to 7 secant theta tan theta d theta. Derivative of secant is secant into tangent. Now the integration I equal to 1 over x square minus 49 under the root dx. It is 1 over 7 tan theta into 7 secant theta tan theta. Now tan theta will cancel. 7 will cancel. You will be left with secant theta d theta. Now please remember, integration of secant kx is 1 over k logarithm natural ln absolute value secant kx plus tan kx. See, sometimes we do not write the absolute value in the answers, sometimes we write, but when you are doing numerical questions you should be very careful. Secant kx plus tan kx, here k equal to 1, so it is, when you integrate secant you will get secant theta plus tan theta. Secant theta we know. Secant theta is how much? X by 7. So no problem. What about tan theta? Tan theta is square root of secant square theta minus 1, which is x by 7 whole square minus 1. You get x square minus 49 by 7. So you can calculate the value of the tangent from the second triangle on the first page. From the third triangle, because we are using the third substitution. So it is the third triangle. Or if you want, you can use the identities. I've used the identities here, but you can also use the basic triangle. Both are equivalent. And in some books, this 7 will be removed using the properties of the logarithm, and it will be combined with this C to get a new C. But we will do the answer like this in this semester. You can stop here in this answer. Now evaluate 1 over 36 plus x square. Now you have to think which substitution to make. It is x equal to 6 tan theta, because square root of 36 is a equal to square root of 36, which is equal to 6. We will put x equal to 6 tan theta. 36 plus x square is equal to 6 square plus 6 square tan square theta. Take 6 square common, you will get 6 square secant square theta. Please, as I told you before, you have to get one thing and should be positive. If that one thing is negative, it is not going to work, because in some questions we have the square roots, and inside the square root it has to be positive. Remember your domains in from your calculus. Now x equal to 6 tan theta, dx equal to 6 secant square theta d theta. Now integration 1 over 36 plus x square dx. Please remember the dx is not equal to d theta. It is 6 secant square theta d theta in this question. Sometimes dx will be equal to d theta, but not in this question. So we'll have 1 over 6 secant theta from the square root which we have here, and the derivative is 6 secant square theta d theta. Now the 6 will cancel. It is power 2 here, power 1 here. You will be left with power 1, which is integration of secant theta. We have seen before, it is secant theta plus tan theta, absolute value inside the natural logarithm. So it is ln absolute value secant theta plus tan theta. Now we have done the substitution. Tan theta is x by 6. But what about secant theta? Secant theta is 1 plus tan square theta under the root. So it is 1 plus x by 6 whole square under the root, which is 36 plus x square. The 6 will come out. This 36 will become 6 after the root, plus x by 6. Tan theta is x by 6. So this is your answer. This 6 can be removed using properties of logarithms, but we are not going to do it. Now again, you can differentiate and check the answer. Now let's do a bigger question. Evaluate 1 over x square minus 9. Now you have to focus on what is in the square root, because this is two things, this is one thing, x square. So let's focus on x square minus 9. Now a equal to square root of 9, which is 3, 9 equal to 3 square. Now go back to page 1. What substitution you have to make for x square minus a square? It is x equal to a secant theta, a equal to 3. So you have x equal to 3 secant theta. That means now after some stage we'll need cos theta. I'll come back to it when we need it. X square minus 9 is x square minus 3 square. X is 3 secant theta. So you'll get 3 secant theta whole square minus 3 square, which is 3 square secant square theta minus 3 square. Take 3 square common, secant square theta minus 1, you'll get 3 square into tan square theta. Use the identities on the first page. You have got one thing here. Now 1 over x square minus 9 under the root will be 3 square secant square theta. And this after the root you'll get 3 tan theta. Now it is 3 cube. 3 square into 3 is 3 power 3. You can write 27 or you can write it like this. 1 over secant square theta tan theta. Just leave it as it is because we have to combine it with dx. Now your integration is 1 over x square minus 9 under the root dx. You will get 1 over 3 cube secant square theta tan theta. Now how much is dx? Dx is 3 secant theta tan theta d theta. We have seen it before in the previous question. Now write it here. Now secant theta tan theta will cancel. You'll be left 1 by secant theta. You have 3 divided by 3 cube, which is 1 over 3 square, 1 over 9. 3 divided by 27 is 1 over 9. Now 1 over secant theta is cosine theta. That's the property of your trigonometric functions. See, 1 divided by secant theta is cos theta, secant theta is 1 by cos theta. So your integration is 1 over 9 cosine theta. Integration of cosine is plus sine theta. So your answer is 1 over sine theta. Now how much is sine theta? Sine theta is square root of 1 minus cosine square. Now you have to, because we made the substitution using secant theta. Secant theta is related to cos theta. Cos theta is 1 by secant theta, which is 3 by x. Now value of this sine theta you can find from the triangle on page 1 or you can find it using the identity. Sine theta is square root of 1 minus cosine square theta. Now cosine is how much? 3 by x. Secant is x by 3, cosine is 3 by x. It gets inverted. You'll get this 1 by 9 is outside, 1 minus 3 by x whole square. You'll get x square minus 9 by x square under the root. It will become x square minus 9 under the root divided by x. And this 1 by 9 is there plus c. Now this 9 and x can be combined. You will get x square minus 9 under the root divided by 9x plus c. Now we have used only one of the three identities. Integration of cosine is plus sine with 1 over k here. So the answer is straightforward, not that difficult. We do not have any secant inverse or cos inverse here because the answer is sine theta. So we are converting sine theta into x using the cos this definition. So you don't have to calculate sine inverse, cos inverse, secant inverse in the first line of the page. Wait till you get your answer. Just put x equal to 3 secant theta. After you get your answer, you decide what you need. Here we need only sine theta. Sine theta is 1 minus cos square theta. So do not do any extra calculations. It consumes time and energy. Now next question. X square integration of divided by, sorry, integral x square divided by 9 minus x square dx. A equal to square root of 9, which is 3, 9 equal to 3 square. If the numbers are not easy, use your calculators. Now it is 9 minus x square under the root. Focus on this. This is part of your question 1, something similar to that. So you put x equal to sine theta. How much sine theta? 3 sine theta. X equal to a sine theta, x equal to 3 sine theta. Again, there is no need to write theta equal to sine inverse x by 3. We don't know whether we need it or not. So you do it after we are sure we need it. 9 minus x square is 3 square minus 3 sine theta whole square. You get 3 square minus 3 square sine square theta. 3 square into 1 minus sine square. You get 3 square into cos square theta. 1 minus sine square is cosine square theta. Now this is 3 square cosine square theta. So square root of 9 minus x square is 3 cosine theta. This kind of substitution we have done before. Now look at your integrand. X square divided by 9 minus x square. X square divided by 9 minus x square is 3 square sine square theta divided by 3 cos theta. Leave it as it is because we have to combine it with dx. If you want, you can cancel the number, but do not do anything to the sine and the cosine. We'll see it in this step what we have to do. हाँ स्टार्ट योर कैलकुलस, एक्स इक्वल टू थ्री साइन थीटा डी एक्स इक्वल टू थ्री कोसाइन थीटा डी थीटा। हाँ पुट योर इंटीग्रेशन इज आई इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल एक्स स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाई नाइन माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर एंड रिमेंबर द डी एक्स एंड डी एक्स इक्वल टू थ्री कॉस थीटा डी थीटा। नाउ कॉपी द होल थिंग फ्रॉम हियर, थ्री स्क्वायर साइन स्क्वायर थीटा डिवाइडेड बाई थ्री कॉस थीटा। नाउ वॉट हैपन्स, दिस थ्री कॉस थीटा विल कैंसल एंड यू विल बी लेफ्ट विथ थ्री स्क्वायर साइन स्क्वायर थीटा। Take 3 square outside, you will get 9 into integration of sine square theta. Now, what's the integration of sine square theta? We have the double angle identity. Let's see what are the rules we need here. We need these double angle identities, 2 sine theta cos theta equal to sine 2 theta, sine square theta equal to half into 1 minus cos 2 theta. We'll need the second identity before the first identity. Then we'll need sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Integration rules which we need are 1 dx integral, which is x plus c, integration of cosine is 1 over k sine kx. Now we have integration of sine square. Now we don't have to do it directly by memorizing big formulae, just convert it into double angle. Sine square theta is half of 1 minus cos 2 theta in the bracket. Take this half outside, we'll get 9 by 2 bracket 1 minus cosine 2 theta. How much is integration of 1? Now there are two things inside, integrate one at a time. Put a big flower bracket, you'll get integration of 1 minus integration of cos 2 theta. Integration of 1 is theta, integration of cosine is sine 2 theta divided by the number inside, which is 2, k equal to 2. So you get theta minus half sine 2 theta. This 9 by 2 is outside, theta you copy in 2, 3 steps. Sine 2 theta is now how much? Your question. Here it is in sine theta. So get rid of the double angle, you'll get 2 sine theta cosine theta. Half into 2 is 1, so it is theta minus sine theta cos theta. 9 by 2 theta minus sine theta. How much is cos theta? Cos theta is 1 minus sine square theta, put it under the root. Then you'll get theta equal to sine inverse x. Sine theta is how much? Look here, it is x by 3. So write x by 3. How much is sine square theta? X by 3 whole square. So you'll get 9x square by 9 square. 9 minus x square, square root of 9 is 3, it comes out. So using from the double angle identity, you get the single angle, and then you have answer is only sine and cosine. Sine substitution you have done. Now you have to worry, theta you know how to calculate using the inverse. Sine theta is by definition x by 3, only cos theta. Cos theta is 1 minus sine square theta, put the value, you get this expression inside the bracket. Now open the bracket, multiply, you'll get 9 by 2 sine inverse x by 3. This 3 into 3 is 9, it will cancel with this, you'll get minus half x into 9 minus x square. You can do this work. But for the double angle, you have to make it half angle. Half of 2 is 1. Half angle, you can say half of 2, or you can say single angle if you are talking about 1 theta. Now, after getting cos theta, you can use the triangle on page 1 if you want, or if you want, you can use this identity. Both are fine, and this is your answer. And the answer can be checked by differentiation. So this is how you do it. And we'll discuss it more in the class, inshallah. See you soon in the class. Thank you.